Growing up is hard when the world doesn't seem to understand me. The vast majority of the world has abilities that I don't have. Abilities that they've grown up with their whole lives and have become second nature. I have something wrong with me. Or at least it feels that way. Something that people can't pinpoint by looking at me. But the way I act and speak and move, they know that something is off. I'm not treated like others either. Some pick on me just for existing, while others attempt to understand me, but get confused or frustrated when I'm unable to do something that they see as straightforward. Even my family members question if I'm fit for a world like this. I want to make mine a household name, to change the world for the better, but there's doubt that I can ever do much of anything. All thanks to some diagnosis I got when I was a kid. In My Hero Academia, 80% of the world has a superpower, which they affectionately refer to as their quirk. I have no quirk in that sense, but I am a rather quirky individual, studying certain topics to the point of obsession. I might not know how to talk to girls, or play sports, or drive a car, but I can write pages upon pages about Animal Planet or Digimon or whatever happens to be my current subject of expertise. As a kid, it was cute. But as I grow older, I recognize the childishness of it all, and I wonder if I'll ever be able to get over it and act like a normal, functioning human being. But then, something incredible happened.
Someone believed in me.
Working with me to learn the skills that I need to survive in this world and develop workarounds for my inherent weaknesses. I soon learned that my quirks are more than just quirks, they're quirks! The in-universe terminology makes that sentence a little confusing. What I mean to say is that certain traits that I was once ashamed of, like my tendency to act based on impulse, are not inherently bad things, and given the right situation, could prove to be as powerful as other people's so-called superpowers, if not more so. It takes time, energy, and patience for all parties involved, but eventually, I'm ready to take on the world all by myself. Moving out, starting a new job, or classes at a new school is tough, but eventually, I'm going to meet even more people who wish nothing but the best for me, and will support me every step of the way. Of course, not everyone's going to understand me all the time. I'm at a point now where people wouldn't necessarily be able to guess that something's different about me, even after spending an extended amount of time around me. People have no idea how hard I fought to get here, nor how much I continue to fight to maintain my social standing. There will still be plenty of situations where I hit a roadblock and others don't quite understand why, but I'm not sure if I should tell them. After all, it's personal. It's touchy. It's none of their business. I've worked so hard to get to this point where I'm not brushed off as the quirkless kid or the autistic kid, that admitting that I still have those flaws could open up some old wounds that I thought were long healed. Still, I push forward, and eventually, my hard work pays off. I start to not only become impressive for those who are like me, but impressive in general. I perform well on tests, get involved with and the relationships I establish with my peers grow even stronger. I feel at home. For a while, anyway. Then things become more dubious. This is where my life and the tale of Izuku, Deku, Midoriya branch off. At the time of recording this, the second season of the My Hero Academia anime is nearly over, and Deku just needs to take one more exam before moving on to his second year of high school. I, on the other hand, am a college graduate. I had the support system I needed in elementary and middle school so that for high school and college, I would be afforded the same opportunities as everyone else. Yet, now that I'm out of school, out of state, and not always surrounded by people who care about me, things have been tough. If anything, I'm back to episodes 1 through 4, before Deku got accepted into UA. Of course, I have family that still believes in me, but beyond that, I have a lot of people who want to put their faith in me, but aren't sure if they can. Case in point, I was recently let go from my job. I got the job by being the only one to call back after initially applying, and they hired me without even giving me an interview. I rushed in without knowing what I was doing, and instead of seeing this as impulsive, they saw it as proactive, and thought that I was worthy of inheriting their power, so to speak. Long story short, I wasn't. I tried to communicate my weaknesses to them, and they did their best to accommodate me, setting up scenarios that they specifically thought I would be able to handle. However, new variables would pop up that were out of either of our control, and when I tried to face them on my own, I would fail and end up relying on my supervisors to resolve these situations for me. After a few too many instances of this, I had to be let go, which leads me to where I am today. Nate Wants to Battle's English cover of the anime's first opening theme sums this up pretty well. Quote, "So many names and faces, sleepless nights spent in unknown places, and every day I walk straight in to the great unknown." Combining this with the imagery from this moment in the official opening creates an interesting juxtaposition. Deku is wandering the streets of Japan, sad and alone, despite the numerous flashing lights and people walking by. As he moves, we see a montage of all the notebooks he's filled out while studying to become a hero. At this point in my journey, I've filled out dozens of notebooks, recording my job leads and taking notes for interviews. And you might be wondering, how is all this possible if it's only been a few weeks since I was fired? Well, the answer is that this isn't exactly my first rodeo, and I have, in fact, been graduated for over 2 years and had to start and stop the job search process many times over. This time, however, I'm in New York City, and while I have been there for over a year now, it's still very much an unknown place, and I can relate to Deku's feeling of being alone while simultaneously being surrounded by tons of people. So, what's next for me? Am I gonna give up? Retire? No. The answer lies in the very next lyrics in Nate's cover. I'm not to blame. I'm gonna take a stand. These lyrics tell me that while there certainly were things that I could have done better in my last position, the reasons for which I got fired were ultimately out of my control, and dwelling on what I could have done differently is ultimately not going to help me move forward. What I need to do is be proactive and go beyond the call of duty. I need to put myself out there, show the world that I am here, and not let the little injuries hurt me in the long run. The truth is, I'm going to fail. Some of it will be my fault, other times I'll do everything right and still not get credit for it. The important thing is that I keep moving forward. I'll apply for jobs, go to interviews, and see if I can't just make it work out here. And if not, I'll formulate a backup plan and see how well that works. It's going to be tough. Hell, it already is. But it does eventually get easier. I just have to do it every day. That's the hard part. In conclusion, I have no idea if Deku is autistic, or if quirks are supposed to represent neurotypical people, or if I'm just putting two and two together and getting five. I was initially going to present this as more of a theory video, but calling this a theory implies that I did all sorts of extended research on autism, when really, I just pulled from my own experiences. Still, I doubt that I'm the only autistic person with a story like this, and I'd love to hear about your experiences and how they compare to or differ from my own. Whether you're autistic or not, though, I think we can all learn something from Deku's journey. It isn't enough to simply go through the motions. The time is upon you to show them what you can do. Go beyond plus ultra!